Move your money, otherwise you're going to lose it. And I can almost guarantee you that that is a correct statement. Money should not be complicated, but because of central banks, lo and behold, it's probably one of the most complicated things on the planet. And because of that, you need to learn about it. Hence the reason why I called it Move Your Money, otherwise you're going to lose it. You need to understand it, learn about it, and also be about a week ahead of everyone else. And without this knowledge, you're at risk of losing valuable assets. The time and sweat that you put into this, you're going to lose it. Even if you were just to park your assets in a savings account, what do you think is going to happen with that? Gone are the days where people could say, and people do still say, save your money, kids. You can't say that anymore, because saving your money, let me give you a prime example. I'll try to do it in under 10 seconds. You decide you go online. Well, you can't go online because back in the day there was no online, but let's just pretend. You go online, you're like, I want to go to Disneyland, even though it's not open right now. And you look and it says $1, because that's how much Disneyland cost to drive on over there. Welcome to Anaheim. Welcome to Disneyland. You pay your buck, you park everything and you're in. Well, that's not the case anymore. Now it's what, $200 plus parking, which is maybe 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. It doesn't matter, because the value of your, I got one right here. The value of your currency, you call it money. It's not actually money. If you can see, this money actually has a hole in it. You can kind of see behind me. That is so weird. But the value of this goes down every single day. So I don't care if you say if you save this all day long, this goes in that direction. Remember that. And people like to call it inflation. I just call it its currency, and all currencies go to zero. I mean, yes, you'll always have this. It'll always say one on it. But your purchasing power, again, goes down. So that's why I labeled this video. And I'm going to give you roughly 8 places, because it's a game. You constantly, you know, do you move it to here? Do you move it over here? Well, which one? Do you move it into cash? Do you move it into stocks? This video, I'm going to go over all of the benefits, the risks, the advantages. But the one thing that you cannot do is just sit there with your money, well, the stuff that you call money, and just let it just sit. That's why I just told you about 20 seconds ago that if you take your money and shove it into a savings account, that you're going to lose it. You're like, no, Bill, it even says, but even banks now, and you're going to hear this, you know how interest rates, depends on when you watch this video, but usually it should be what, maybe 15%? I think that's a good savings rate, 10, 15%. We're all the way down to almost zero. And then after that, you're going to have this little minus thing in front of it, which I cannot believe that this is going to happen, but that's because of central banks. You're actually going to lose money by putting your money in the bank account. But in this video, we're going over 8. And if I come up with another one, 9. 9 different places that you need to move your money. Otherwise, you're going to lose it. And we're starting right now. Welcome back to my channel, and if you are new here, my name doesn't matter, because this channel is about you, helping you move your money, how to make money, how to start businesses and go, oh, what do I do with the said money? We're going to invest it. Well, how do I invest it so I don't lose it? Because I just bought Tesla at $950, or I just bought Bitcoin at $20,000. Now it's where to go. If you like this kind of stuff on how to make money and how not to lose it, consider subscribing. It's just a little itty bitty click. And then I'm not going to sell you a darn thing. Well, you know, there could be affiliates or things like that. But generally speaking, I'm a high school business teacher. I have 6 kids. Life's crazy over here in Southern California. And I'm just trying to give you guys as much information, my knowledge that I got in here, give it to you. And hopefully you can make money, save money, and in the end, not lose money. And you have my promise that I'll never hold up stuff like this and go, you know what, buy my gold, link in the description, the world's going to end. Because there's always 2 sides. There's actually more than 2 sides. There's probably 100 sides to every coin. That's crazy, Bill. There can't be 100 sides to every coin. But I bet you if you took this gold coin right now, and we're going to talk about gold, silver, all this kind of stuff, there's lots of sides on this. See all the ridges? Plenty of sides. but I'm going to give you all the sides, and I'm not going to, anything that I sell you, I actually do. And I make sure it works. And then I tell you the risks, the advantages and the disadvantages. But let's dive into little me and big picture so I can show you all the different places that you can move your money. All right, here we go. I cannot see my face. All I see is a bunch of circles, and I'm going to show you each place to move your money, when to, why, how, and hopefully my hair is not covering it. In post editing, I may have to fix this, but I'm just going off where I think I might be. But the very first place we're going to look at is over here. And this has been a very hot topic in the market, stocks. How do we buy stocks? What do? I use a multitude of different platforms to buy stocks, but you can't be a buy and holder, in my opinion. Now, I have to say this. None of this is financial advice. Don't listen to anything that I say. I'm not your broker. Do your due diligence on all of these assets that I'm going to talk to you about. They are very volatile, whichever tomato or a tomato. They go up and down very quickly, and you need to know how to trade this stuff. And depending on how long this video is, I'm going to show you how I personally trade each asset. I'll teach you how I trade. For example, this is very common. People are like, S&P 500 is up today. The NASDAQ is up today. It's down today. Like, where do you need to be on the other side of this play? Because money, assets, money is mostly made on the way down, and it's made at the bottom. So money is not made at the top. Money is sold at the top. It is made on the way down. And as some of you may know very quickly, crypto, gold took a beating this week. Stocks definitely took a beating. How low can it go? And so when people are like, Bill, it's a perfect time to buy. I'm like, what are you even talking about? And I'm going to draw something for you. See this line? It's called, let's say you decide, you know what? I want to buy the NASDAQ. And you know, you go all in. All right, cool. Well, why did you get in? And when are you going to get out? You have to have a stop loss. Any wise trader, don't even talk to me unless you have put in a stop loss. So when your stock, your NASDAQ goes down and it hits that stop loss, you're out. Yes, you lost some money, but you didn't lose all of your money. Okay? And now people that are down here, they're like, well, it always comes back, right? That's the mantra, right? It always comes back. That's their short-sightedness, the this is all I know. Talk to people in 1929 that had to wait 30 years just to break even again. Next on my list is the bond market. This is a lot of fun. Now, crazy as it is, because of the repo market and the exchanges, the repurchasing agreements, they're using bonds are actually very important, like probably just as much as important as the stock market. And what's happening is there's liquidity that's drying up. I don't want to go into too much detail. Just know that the bond market is just going berserk right now because this is what banks trade back and forth. So let's dive back in. Oh, before I forget, if you haven't yet because of the stupid algorithms, I'm so sorry. I never want look at my Instagram. You don't even see me ever talk my Instagram, my Twitter, my, you know, whatever, Snapchat, none of that. I don't need the likes, but I do for these videos. Darn you, Tube. All right, but I don't want to forget about the current T-bill rate. You're going to get a whopping 0.43, 0.39, 0.40, and a half a point. A month ago, talk about securities and the crash that has happened. A month ago, 1.5, now 0.43. So that is that. Moving on to the bond, I think this is the bond market. The yields are 0.24, 0.72. This is definitely supposed to be your safety, but I have a big feeling you're not okay with getting 0% on your return. That is correct. So you need to move it. But if you think about it, if you were in the bond market, in your T-bills, when these took a dive, or other things that we're going to talk about. But we are moving on to bigger and better things. And the bigger and better things are this guy and this guy. Gold and silver, whatever commodities, you know, But we're going to focus, because I got to kind of narrow it down. Don't be so broad, Bill. You get us all confused. We're going to stick with this guy right here. And there's been a decoupling from this, and I'm going to show you. And as you can see here, the price of physical gold is decoupling from the paper gold. As you can see right here, we have an American Eagle, which I showed you just a second ago. We're looking at a 1 ounce at $1,750, but the paper gold price is quite a bit lower. So if you were like, wow, gold really took a beating. Well, did it? Yeah, the paper, the ETFs, the stuff that, the derivatives, yeah, $1,529. But the physical gold, this stuff right here, is going up. And also, please be really careful. The people above my head, they have one thing to sell, and a lot of times it's fear. And that fear causes you to run to their safe haven or away from another one. But you need to know this stuff, this crazy chart right here. And since I got you on the line, I'll do a quick little trade for you. So again, not financial advice. I'm going to try to keep this under 1 minute. Let's start the timer, Bill. This is the 4 hour on TradingView. I may leave a link in the description of TradingView. I'll do a lot of this on this channel because again, this channel, dang it, I'm going to go over a minute. This channel is about helping you and I want to be practical and show you. There's both sides. Yes, you can just, it's so like dumb. Just go buy real gold. Yeah, okay. It has its time, okay? But know how to trade this. Otherwise, you're going to lose a lot of money. So how I would enter this position is, and I'm going to try to make this real simple. As it comes down, I give this as an example, like Southern California surfer. It goes up, it comes down, it comes up. I enter a position. So on this one, I would enter it. No, I don't want to lose money. Hold on, wrong one. Let me zoom on this one. Zooming always. Okay, can we see it? We can see it more gooder. Perfect. Think of it like a jet ski, and this is a wave. I have a indicator on my 20. I'm not going to go into detail. Small indicators. MACD, RSI. This shows me momentum. Again, so here we go. We come up over the wave. Okay, under. See these bars? We want the bars under. All right. And then we're going to pop up. And the minute it pops up right there, see that one? Let me use this tool. One candle needs to be the candle, not the wick, above the 20. Yeah, we're on the 20, right? One candle above, there's 101 different ways to skin a cat. There's 101 different ways to trade a market. This is trading it in a bull market. I buy, and then the minute the candle goes underneath the line, I sell. So on this trade, now gold, you know, could be kind of boring. Little trades here. That one, yeah, half a percent, whatever. No big deal. Again, it comes, it goes up, momentum up, down, under. One candle above the line. Now, it depends on how religious you want to be. One of those. So I would buy this one at, you know, gold at 1,572. And I would ride this all the, wow, this was a good one. You guys getting it? So we're at this candle. And I'll also leave a coupon or something in the description. My friend actually has a whole course on this. I don't have time to do a course on it. I'm focusing on a different one on trading. But just hang out in my channel and I'll teach you how to trade. This again, do you see it, the wicks? Don't worry about it. Wicks. Nope. Full body candle closed right here. We're out. I made 4.815% on that trade. Now, as you see, if it starts moving down, okay, we're going to flip it and we're going to click the button that says short. And it's the same thing. Or you can get an ETF that shorts gold or shorts the SQQQ. That would be the opposite of the NASDAQ, which I'll get to that in just a moment. Okay, so there we have it. We have physical gold, great. And then we have a derivative of gold. Not so great. Be very careful unless you're trading it. You get it when it goes up. You have standards that you use. You get it when it goes down. This is a whole nother ball game on how to trade. So we covered stocks. We covered bonds and T-bills. Check. We did gold. Physical gold. Look, see, I'm making a profit on my physical gold because I moved my money, okay, I have to move my money. I have to allocate it somewhere else. And I have to think ahead of the game. Where do I think this game's going to go? And you have to be there to trade it too. You just can't, you know, sit there. I wish, guys, if you did want to, though, just holding physical gold is money. Money has a needs to have a store of value over a long period of time. So physical gold will retain your wealth. So if you just want to just not make any money and just kind of keep it, I think not financial advice, but what I do, I hold physical gold. So you don't really have to sweat it. So just go buy it and just, I guess you could buy and hold that. You don't really have to worry about it too much. But where the real money is made, it's always made right there. Boy, oh boy, this, I could do 101 billion different videos on how money works and we would never get to the bottom of it. But yeah, holding currency in this kind of state could be beneficial when the markets lock up and, you know, the cards don't work. What do you got? You know, am I going to go to the store and buy something with that? They'll be confused. Again, these are just assets that I'm moving. They'll definitely take this. So why wouldn't I? But again, like I said earlier, if you hold this for too long, it goes down in value. If you hold crypto for too long, it goes down in value. If you hold stocks for too long, it goes down in value. You need to be moving it. You can't just, again, if you want, you could just buy gold and let it sit there. But you're not really moving wealth there. It's money. It just kind of sits there. Bill brought up crypto. I know a lot of my audience, I have audiences all over the place. I have, you know, this channel was created about money and how to make it and not lose it and starting businesses. So I got that. I got some crypto peeps in the hood. And here we go. Here's Bitcoin. Are you in a trade on this? My answer is no. I am shorting this. You can, like I say, just taught you how to trade a little bit. See, it goes under, it comes up. So maybe you're like, okay, cool. We go under and then we pop up. No full candle close above. There is no trade happening. This, if you, and I don't want to show you guys shorting. If you flip the chart upside down, you do it the other way. There is no buy here. There is no buy here. There is no buy. Bye-bye. I don't want to go into trading this, but again, you need to know how to get in. You need to know how to get out, and you also set stop losses. I mean, could Bitcoin go to $1,500? It actually could. It could because people were shocked that it actually Bitcoin right here, 3,000 what? 3,700. Everyone said it could never happen. Really? Well, you better have stop losses in. Like I said, I do. And I've done videos in the past on Bitcoin. Yes, there is a chance, there is likelihoods that Bitcoin could reach $100,000 based on, but I don't care about that. That's news. These are, yeah, well, you got this and then you have the halving and okay, great. I get it. That's more so news, but that affects the price and Tesla and they're going to open up so many, you know, gigafactories and that affects price. I understand, but I don't trade news. I trade technicals. So if you want, follow all those YouTubers, listen to all their hype about all of that. But I'm not buying into it. I've lost enough money in my past to know how to make safe investments. And I'm just going to label this one BTC. That's good old Bitcoin. Now you can trade all the other coins. I don't care what you trade. Have an entry and an exit. I believe it's an asset. I believe stocks are assets, crypto's assets, bonds are assets, cash, gold, these are all assets. And here's one of my favorite, and I apologize, let's see, if I move this way, can you see it better? Or if I move that way, can you see it better? It's real estate. Real estate's awesome. Now, okay, here we go. And I know a lot about real estate. That's what I do also. I could probably have a whole channel on it, but I don't. Buy real estate and stick a renter in there or buy a place that is that I have. I have units, I have rental units and they pay me every month and that's passive income. But don't think that the real estate market isn't going to get hit by this because that's just what happens. Assets decouple, they go down, they go up. It all depends on what market we're in. I like holding real estate as long as it's a place that I can have a renter in it. So I will move my money into real estate, or I will move my cash into real estate, or I will move my stocks into real estate. These are just, now these are bigger plays. Real estate's a big play, so you gotta make money in other areas and then move it. But one of my favorite is definitely buying a place in wherever, Nebraska, that you pick up for $50,000 or $75,000, low, you know, little monthly payment of say $500 or $400 or $300, whatever, and you have a renter in there paying you $1,200. And this top one up here, we're just gonna call it MF, because that's what I feel like. Mutual funds. A lot of times you can't move them, especially if it's like a 403B, 401K. About 2 months ago, I was trying to get out of my 403B. I was doing everything that I could because they saw it coming. And I'm like, out, I got to move this. And they're like, nope, you can't. No, I'm like, I'll pay whatever fees. Nope, you can't. So I've lost a lot of money there. I don't think I need to go into too much detail of what mutual funds are. They're just stocks, okay? Mutual funds, they're just a group of stocks that you pay fees that you really don't have too much control over. I like to have control over my assets. I like to have control over my money because I have to move it. And last but not least, and I know you see one over here. I don't think I'm gonna have time on this one. This is sad. Maybe in another video. I just feel like this video is gonna go way too long. Is starting a business on Amazon, on eBay, going out there learning a private label product, bringing something to market, like a water bottle or all of the things that I sell on Amazon. This generates me passive income and it's wicked cool because I'm like, oh, cool. I sold a bunch of this today. Or, you know, you could even make this one starting a YouTube channel and generating passive income from this little guy right here, because that would make you happy, right? Because passive income makes us happy. Yay! But I'll leave a link in the description. I only offer one per video. It's usually gone pretty quickly. I have two courses. One's roughly 80 videos. The other one's like 40 on how to start your own business or how to do online arbitrage business. And it's changed my life. Oh, and one more thing. If there is that link in the description for Charlie, that's his trading platform. He has a course on it. If it's there, grab it. If not, because I'm working out to make sure you guys get a deal, an offer. And I never give other people stuff unless I really trust them. So if it's there, if it's not, it's not. And we will catch you in the next video.